guys, welcome back. How are you feeling from yesterday's workout? Today we're gonna do a few more exercises to work on our booty. So let's get right to it. I have five different exercises for you today. And the first one is going to be a single leg bridge. So come down on our mats. And this is what it's gonna look like. You're going to bridge, push through your heels. I like to bring my feet in so that my hands can touch them. Push through your heels. You're gonna bring one leg up and then down. Don't actually touch the ground, just hover right above, and then push through that other heel. So down, up, down, up. That's what it looks like, and then we'll switch up legs. All right, everyone ready? Up, bring your leg up, and here we go. Make sure you press through that heel. Make sure you're breathing. We don't want to hold our breath during these. Let's do three more. Excellent. Switch the legs. And up. Here we go. Good job. You want to draw your abs in, but this isn't an ab workout necessarily. We're working this glute right here. You're also going to feel it in your hamstrings. Keep going. Two more. Excellent. Great job. All right, come up. The next move we're going to do, we are going to be on all fours, and we are going to be doing, it's called the rainbow. So you're going to be on your forearms. I'll show you what it looks like before we get started. So you're like this. You're going to bring your foot out, tap your toe, and then bring it over and touch behind. So up and over, up and over. When you do this, you really want to draw your abs in to protect your low back. All right? Are we ready? Toe out, up and over, up and over. Good job. Keep those abs pulled in. Make sure you're breathing. Good job. Make sure you're squeezing. Do three more. One. Two. Three. Great job. All right, let's switch up and do the other leg. Here we go. Go out, and up, and touch. Make sure that we always have to take our low back, draw those abs in. To lunge and then up and over. Again, you want to make sure your shoulders are forward facing. You don't want your knee to go in front of your toes. All right? Everyone ready? If you really want to make it a little more challenging, hold some hand weights. All right? Here we go. In the back leg, you don't want it to hit the floor, but you want to come close to the floor if you can. you have a string pulling you from the top of your head. Keep you in an upright position. Keep your chest lifted. You're really going to be feeling it on this outside leg here. Do one more. And we're going to switch sides. All right? So here we go. Oops, I'm going to run into the fireplace. So I need my head cut off, huh? Down and up. You might notice one leg, you are feeling it a little more than the opposite. That's totally fine. Good job. Keep going. Do three more. Make sure you're pressing through that heel when you come up. Last one. Excellent. Put your legs out. Next move is a heel lift squat. So, for this we're going to come with our feet a little bit wider than hip width apart. And what you're going to do is you're going to come down the squat, but you're going to lift this heel, the right heel, off the ground. We're going to keep it lifted the whole time. All right? So you're really going to squeeze on that left glute. All right? Here we go. Down, and again, you really want to make sure that you are keeping your chest lifted, your abs drawn in, keep your knees behind your toes, and the best way to make sure you're doing that is to press through your heels, and think about sitting in a chair as you go down. Good job. Keep going. Keep that heel off the ground. Let's do five more. Make sure you're breathing. Last one. Excellent. Take it out. And we're gonna switch it up. So, same thing, come down. Now the left heel is gonna stay off the ground. So, here we go. When you come up, squeeze your glutes and thrust your hips forward. It's gonna help you to have that good form. Keep going. I know your legs and your glutes are screaming. Keep it up. If you need to take a break and shake it out, do so, but jump right back in. Do two more. Woo! Great job. Okay, one last move for today. You guys are almost finished. Great job. So, we are going to do a single leg deadlift. So I'll show you first. So you're going to have, one leg is going to be straight and one leg is going to be back. You can kind of touch in the floor for balance or you can elevate it, totally fine. So what you're going to do, you're going to hinge from the waist, keep your abs drawn in, your shoulders back. You're going to come forward and then you're going to keep this leg straight as far as you can. And then squeeze up with your glutes. I want you to keep your back flat, do not round it. All right, here we go. So it looks like this. It's really gonna test your balance, that's why it's okay to put that back foot down if you need to. Keep that leg straight. These are really challenging. It's not only working your legs and your glutes, it's also working your balance. See, I like to bring the leg in as I come up because it helps me balance. Keep breathing. If you want, you have your leg hands down, whatever helps you with your balance. Do two more. Really squeeze through that glute as you come up. Last one. Whew. Legs are burning. I don't know about you. All right, switch it up. Other leg. Okay, so your left leg is back, your right leg is forward. Keep those abs drawn in. Here we go. Down. See, my balance is the worst on this side. Up. Put my arm. arms down sometimes because I've done these with weights before, and it kind of helps me with the like counterbalance of my foot. It's totally up to you what you do, but you want to make sure that you keep your abs drawn in. And when you go back, when you're coming forward, you're squeezing from your glutes and your hamstring to bring you forward. Press through that heel, squeeze. Oops. It's okay if you lose your balance. Just keep going. Keep your shoulders back. Great job. One more. Excellent job. So, that is today's workout. If you really want to up it, don't take breaks in between each exercise. Like I said, beginner is one round. Intermediate is two rounds, advanced is three rounds, and you also, if you really want to FA, add some hand weights and don't take breaks in between each round. So let me know what you thought today. Comment below. Let us know if you did beginner, intermediate, and advanced. Be sure to share a tasty, healthy recipe.